The last plot type that we are going to look at is making a bar chart. We're going to go ahead and take our CO2 sector data, but this time we're going to look at the total CO2 emissions of the states instead of looking at them by sector so that we can see, compare the size of them. And we're going to take our CO2 sector data frame, but we're only going to go through from Alabama through Wyoming. This will eliminate the total row that's at the bottom of the data set. So if I do this, I can see that I have created a panda series that contains only the state totals. If I go ahead and tell it to create a horizontal bar chart, it does that quite easily. However, because the plot size is a bit small, the names are all jumbled over the top of each other. Also, as I mentioned earlier, Alabama is at the bottom and Wyoming is at the top. So it might make more sense from our normal way of thinking of things to have them in alphabetical order from top to bottom rather than bottom to top. So we can do manipulations like this. We can take our totals by state data view that we created and sort it according to the index, which is the state name, but have it be descending instead of ascending. And then we can create the horizontal bar chart with a larger figure size than what I used before. And if I run that code, then the chart, it's still a bit on the big side, but it is easy enough to read all the different states and to get a feel for which states are the largest emitters of CO2 and which ones are among the smallest.